India becomes rich. I wish this university will take the lead in that and try to make many startups come, many research happens here, many innovations come here, and many basic research related technologies develop here and show the way to the various other universities. I'm sure Swamiji will be leading in that. And my best wishes to all of you. Once again, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Jai Hind. Thank you.
In introducing Dr. S. Jairam Reddy, Honorable Chancellor of SESVMB. Prior to being associated with us, Dr. Reddy has been the Vice Chancellor of different universities in India and has to his credit the rich experience of successfully performing such dynamic roles. Dr. Jairam Reddy is an eminent scholar in the field of electrochemistry with more than 20 application-oriented researches to his credit. Besides this, he has published more than 250 research papers and review articles in various reputed professional journals of both Indian and international origin in his extensive career spanning over 4 decades. He has authored 4 books in the fields of fundamental, electro and environmental chemistry, guided 35 PhD scholars and 9 MPhil researchers in these 4 decades. He is an acclaimed teacher with a dozen of Indian and international universities, colleges, to which he visits regularly to deliver lectures on special topics in the field of chemistry. A luminary in the sphere of higher education, Professor Dr. S. Jairam Reddy has to his credit the vice chancellorships of many prestigious universities with a bouquet of awards and prizes for academic and administrative excellence. He has been the head of Higher Education Council of the government of the erstwhile state of Andhra Pradesh. He has visited a number of countries on academic assignments within India. He has traveled extensively to various education institutions as a member or a head of the peer team for inspections representing NAC or UGC, thereby gaining a deeper understanding of the dynamics of governing higher education institutions. As an educationist par excellence and an able administrator, the Chancellor has been motivating us and guiding us in our effort to put the Vishwamahavidyalaya on the map of the nation. I welcome you, sir, and request you to address the graduates.
Jaya Jaya Shankara. Hara Hara Shankar. My pranamams to His Holiness Pujya Sri Shankara Vijayendra Saraswati Swamigal, Dr. Satish Reddy Garu, eminent scientist and chief guest of today's convocation, distinguished personalities on and off the dais, learned Vice Chancellor Mr. Raghavan, our managing trustee, members of the Board of Management and Academic Council, my good friend Dr. Sharma, and other recipients of the honorary degrees, Registrar, Chief Administrative Officer, Deans of Faculties, Heads of Departments, faculty members, stars of today's celebration, young graduates waiting to be entering their new lives, members of the parents and alumni associations, members of the print and electronic media, invitees, ladies and gentlemen. I am very much delighted and deem it as an honor to welcome you all to the 22nd convocation of our university. This is a great occasion for all of us, and we should remember and convey our prayers to Sri Shankara Bhagavat Padam and the great Mahaswami Paramacharya, seeking their divine blessings on this auspicious day. Students all over the world wait for this big day, the day of convocation. This day is important for the university and the students as well. We all feel proud seeing the young boys and girls coming out in flying colors with the diplomas and degrees in your hands to begin a new journey. I congratulate all the students who have successfully completed the course and would be receiving the degrees to enter the professional world. I also congratulate the faculty and staff who, I am sure, are equally proud of producing these graduates. It must be a moment of joy for the proud parents, and I congratulate them. The task of a university, as all of you agree, is to create a future that is sound and great. Nowadays, we are to educate students and create knowledge for a global environment that is more connected, more diverse, more threatened, and more interdependent than that we have seen in previous generations. Our mission is to prepare the next generation of leaders, advance human health, inspire innovation and entrepreneurship, and enhance the quality of life. The quest for excellence should finally lead it to the best level of educational performance and become not only comparable to the leading universities in India and the world, but also serve as a benchmark for others. With the kind blessings of His Holiness, Pooja Sri Shankara Vijayendra Saraswati Swamiji, our university is trying its best to provide the best quality education here, and I am sure the university will secure soon its pride of place among the top ranking universities. My dear young graduates, technology is perhaps the greatest agent of change in the modern world. Although never without risk, technological breakthroughs promise solutions to the most pressing global challenges of our time, from zero emission cars fueled by hydrogen to computer chips modeled on the human brain, provide us a glimpse of the power of innovation to improve lives, transform industries, and safeguard our planet. Turning our attention to some of the latest technological inventions, Dr. Satish Reddy Garu has clearly explained to us the advances made in the field of defense. And we are really proud of the developments, the advances that have taken place in the defense field, which is making us feel proud to be a nation in the entire world community. The latest simple invention, gravity light, looks to address the electricity problem very easily. This is a light that requires no electricity, no batteries, no solar dependency to operate. Instead, it uses the force of gravity to create light. It's a very great development. A company predicts consumers will be able to build their own full-scale, fully functional, customized cars in about an hour using advanced 3D printing technology. The co-inventor of Twitter He is now promoting his latest invention called the square. The square is a small plug-in attachment to your mobile phone that allows you to receive credit card payments. The Bahrain World Trade Center is the first skyscraper to have wind turbines integrated into the structure of the building, which supply about 15% of the electricity used by the skyscraper. Approximately the same amount of electricity used by 300 homes. Biomimicry is the science that imitates nature to create new products. A Wisconsin-based company has created a tire that can't go flat. This is the airless tire with uniform flexibility and load transfer that would endure tremendous wear and tear and still perform well. Drones are becoming more popular too, particularly with the unveiling of a new Chinese drone that can carry around a human. Building human organs is soon becoming a reality. The latest science invention in technology, which allows living tissue cells to be assembled into patterns and complex structures such as organs. The bioprinter developed prints human cells in a three-dimensional matrix to construct human tissue and can grow blood vessels. It is anticipated that within 3 years, the device will construct arteries, and by 2020, sophisticated organs will be built by the device. Also, there is increasing optimism that nanotechnology applied to medicine and dentistry will bring significant advances in the diagnosis, treatment, and prevention of diseases, including cancer, heart disease, and other common illnesses. Human settlement of Mars is going to be the next giant leap for humankind. The organic battery developed generates a charge within 10 seconds and will last anywhere from 2 days to a week, depending on the liquid. So the list is endless, you know, which shows abundance of research is going on in the world. Now that you are graduates, due to many technological wonders that have happened already, a host of new challenges and options are on your horizons. It is the most critical time for life-changing decisions. The world awaits you to know what steps will you choose. This is the time to discover your life's destiny. So be adventurous, be spontaneous, and dare to be different in the world. Globalization has created both interrelated and interlinked world, generating opportunities and also thrown many challenges. For you young graduates, technocrats, I believe sky is the limit. If they dream high and act with determination and conviction, you are bound to get the reward. When it comes to the availability of scientists and engineers, we are ranked in the world fourth. But in terms of technological readiness, about which our chief guest was also mentioning, we rank 83rd because of low penetration of technology in our society. Instead of followers, we should also become the people who really discover. An advice to our proud graduates: if you really, really believe in something, keep going after it, because there is always a way and you can make your dreams come true. I am sure that I am speaking the minds of all of us here when I say that on an occasion like this, special tribute should be paid to the founding fathers of this university. This university has been founded to inculcate human values, blended education. We are an institution built on truth And our mission is to uncover, preserve, create, and always use truth as our guiding star. The complexities of present-day management with too many uncertain parameters call for a creative approach to provide innovative solutions to problems. Also remember that the greatest satisfaction in one's life lies in giving something back to the society which gave you the scope to be what you are today. We are highly fortunate today to have with us His Holiness Pooja Sri Sankara Vijayendra Saraswati Swamigal to shower His blessings on us. Adi Shankara once said about the great effect and influence of presence of godlike persons on any occasion. Ganga papam, Shashi tapam, Dainyam kalpataru tada, papam tapancha dainyancha hanti sajjana sangati. Ganga mata only relieves sins. Moon relieves heat. Kalpa Vruksha relieves dainya. But the presence of Yogiswar, godlike Swamiji, relieves us from all these three, either dainya or tapa or sins. So we are really blessed by you, by your presence here on this auspicious occasion, and I am personally, as a Chancellor, I am grateful to you for your presence here. On behalf of all the members of the SC, SV, MV, University family, we congratulate you again and pray for your success in life. Please keep in mind that in today's world of competition, the most important competition is between you and your imagination. Thanks for your kind attention.
Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Parambrahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam. Tannudaiya Guruvana Sri Chandrasekharendra Saraswati Swamigalin Peyaral அவர்களுடைய நூற்றாண்டு விழாவை கொண்டாடும் விதமாக தன்னுடைய குருவின் மீது இருக்கக்கூடிய பக்தி மரியாதையின் காரணமாகவும் ஏழைகள் படித்தவர்கள் படிக்காதவர்கள் எல்லா பகுதி மக்களுடைய வளர்ச்சி மேம்பாட்டின் மீது இருந்த அக்கறையின் காரணமாகவும் நம்முடைய பெரியவர்களால் ஆரம்பிக்கப்பட்டது இந்த சந்திரசேகரேந்திர சரஸ்வதி விஸ்வ மகாவித்யாலயா. 10,000 கிலோமீட்டருக்கும் அதிகமாக அவர்கள் பாதயாத்திரை செய்து பாரத தேசத்தினுடைய அனைத்து பிரதேசங்களையும் பார்த்து அங்கு இருக்கக்கூடிய புண்ணியக்ஷேத்திரங்கள் அங்கு இருக்கக்கூடிய பல்வேறு மானுமெண்ட்ஸ் அரிய விஷயங்கள் எல்லாம் பார்த்து இந்த காஞ்சிபுரத்தை வளர்க்க வேண்டும். காஞ்சிபுரத்திலே நல்ல பல ஸ்தாபனங்கள் வர வேண்டும் என்பதற்காக பல முயற்சிகளை அவர்கள் செய்துள்ளார்கள். காமாட்சியம்மன் கோவிலே தங்க விமானம், தங்க ரதம் இது போன்று கோவிலை மேம்படுத்த